Our next poster number 2, is titled Prevalence and Knowledge of Hypoglycemia Among Type 2 Diabetic Patients on Insulin Therapy Attending a Tertiary Care Diabetic Clinic. The authors are Priyadarshini SMS, Abhay Ratna SA, and Garusinghe JC. The presenting author is Priyadarshini SMS.
Good morning, everybody. I'm SMS Priyadarshini. My research is about prevalence and knowledge of hypoglycemia among type 2 diabetes patients on insulin therapy attending a tertiary care diabetic clinic. Hypoglycemia is one of the most feared complications of insulin treatment. The objective of this study was to determine prevalence and knowledge of hypoglycemia among patients with type 2 diabetes who were on insulin. This was a descriptive cross-sectional study carried out at the Diabetic Clinic of National Hospital of Sri Lanka. Randomly selected 380 type 2 diabetic patients on insulin with or without other antidiabetic agents with a history of diabetes at least for 6 months duration were selected. Data was collected using pre-tested interviewer-administered questionnaire and patient clinic records. According to results, majority were female. Mean age was 60 years, duration of diabetes was 16 years. About 69% had symptoms of hypoglycemia within the considered one year period of time. Most of the patient knew faintishness as the symptom of hypoglycemia. The commonest symptoms of hypoglycemia experienced by the patient were faintishness and sweating. Nearly quarter of symptomatic patients reported severe hypoglycemia and 8.4% patients reported unconscious episodes. Clinically important hypoglycemia was reported by 34.7% patients. Only 25% of patients had correct knowledge regarding hypoglycemic symptoms, precipitation factors, and preventive measures. Reporting of hypoglycemic symptoms to the medical staff was done by 58.65% patients only. The more important risk factor of hypoglycemia were reduced meal amount and missing or delayed meals. Herbs were used by 42.4% patients. There was no significant association of herbs usage and occurrence of symptomatic hypoglycemia. According to conclusion and recommendations, though patient on insulin had high prevalence of hypoglycemia, a large number didn't report it at their routine clinic visits. Knowledge about identification and prevention of hypoglycemia were poor. Routine inquiry about hypoglycemic episodes during the clinic review and frequent education programs would help in detection and prevention of hypoglycemic episodes. Thank you.
Thank you. The paper is now open for discussion.
It's a good presentation. Just one question. Was there any recurrence of hypoglycemic attack? Did you look into that? That's one attack or two, three attacks or something?
We considered only one attack.
So all of them had only one attack?
Within considered period, at least one attack they should have.
Didn't ask about how many attacks you had during that time. No?
We asked if they have only one attack also, so we included that.
Thanks.
So you mentioned the randomly selected sample.
Yes.
So what's the procedure you followed? What is the sample frame?
Randomly, I select random numbers. And
What was the sample frame?
About 100.
What is the sample frame? How do you get the sample frame if you are following a clinic patient?
Yes, about 150.
I'm asking what is the sample frame? How do you get the sample frame if you are using the random sample?
Yes.
So you must have a sample frame.
Random checker I have used.
You just explain what's the procedure you followed?
About 150 to 200 patients attended to diabetic clinic. Among them, using random checker, I used random numbers, about 5 or 6 numbers per day. Then I have given those numbers to those patients and selected those patients among 150 to 200 patients.
Thank you. Please give a round of applause to our presenter.